My dear children, welcome to the business studies class. Today in this session we are going to study a new chapter, that is international business. Let me ask one question. What is meant by the term trade? Yes, the term trade means purchase or sale of goods and services with the motive of earning profit. Trade can be internal trade or external trade. International business is as old as civilization. Even in ancient times, when means of transport were slow and few, merchants from one country used to trade with those from other countries. However, such trading was conducted on a small scale. After the Industrial Revolution, international business assumed greater significance and is now conducted on large scale. The international business refers to the business activities that take place across the national boundaries. This international business involves manufacturing and trade beyond the geographical boundaries of the country. It is different from domestic business, which involves business transactions within the boundaries of a nation. International business involves not only international movement of goods and services. It also includes the movement of capital, personnel, technology, and intellectual property across the national boundaries. International business is a wider term than international trade. In addition to exports and imports, it comprises international trade in services, foreign investments, overseas production of goods and services. The basic reason behind international business is geographical specialization. Every country specializes in the production of those goods and services which it can produce at lower cost. It buys other goods and services through trade with other countries which they can produce at lower cost. Different countries have different natural resources. Moreover, labor productivity and cost of production differ from country to country due to various socio-economic, geographical and political reasons. The business firm may import what is available at lower prices in other countries. It may export these items which can fetch better prices in other countries than at home. The special features of international business, which are also its complexities, are the first one, distance. Distance is the important feature of international business. Industries of all over the world are undergoing a fundamental shift in the way that produces the market various products and services. The national economies, which so far were pursuing the goal of self-reliance, are now becoming increasingly dependent on others for procuring as well as supplying various kinds of the goods and services. Due to increased cross-border take and trade and investments, countries are no more isolated. The prime reason behind this radical changes in the development of communication, technology, infrastructure, etc., the emergence of newer modes of communication and development of faster and more efficient means of transportation have throughout the nations closer to one another. The business transactions taking place within the geographical boundaries of a nation is called domestic or national business. It is also referred to as international business or home trade. Manufacturing and trade beyond the boundaries of one's own country is known as international business. Next, we are going to study the reasons for international business. The fundamental reason behind the international business is that the countries cannot produce equally well or cheaply all that they need. This is because of unequal distribution of natural resources among them or differences in their productivity levels. Availability of various factors of production such as labor, capital and raw materials that are required for producing different goods and services differ from nations. Moreover, the labor productivity and the production cost differ from nation to various nations, then to various socio-economic, geographic and political reasons. Then due to these differences, it is not unknown to find out one particular country being a better position to produce better quality products. In other words, we can say that some countries are in an advantageous position in producing selected goods and services which other countries cannot produce that effectively and efficiently, and vice versa. As a result, each country finds it advantageous to produce those selected goods and services that it can produce more effectively and efficiently at home.